Hi guys, and welcome back to one of my video. Paolo of GT40 Model Works here. And the model that I wanted to show you today, it was a kit that I made also here, in a little kind of unlucky, let me say, before any of the modern quality producer made available as an ordinary plastic kit. I mean, this was a plastic kit from the beginning, but it was not absolutely what it was described on the box art of the Fujimi kit. So this is a BMW M3 E30. That was the very first M3 available around, and it was absolutely a nice racer. The car itself was, in my opinion, one of the nicest BMW ever produced, ever of back in time, you know. So the issue was that before you find the B-Max kit around, you just have to be related to the, I have to say, sorry Japanese guy, don't get angry at me, but it was absolutely crap at the time, the crap model of Fujimi. So this is not the B-Max, this is the Fujimi kit that have been completely hugely modified in the look to look similar, I guess, to the real BMW M3, you know, because back in time, when you cannot do so much, the only possibility that you had to make an E30 M3, it was just to take the Fujimi kit, and or you didn't see the difference, you simply build it up straight from the box, and the final overall look, in my opinion, was more than a BMW, looked like a Volvo at the end, looked like a Volvo 940, you know, completely squared, different model. And probably this was not only my feeling, but also the feeling of many modelers around. That's why back in time, you're talking of the end of the 90s, beginning of the 2000, you know, the Studio 27 company from Japan made a very, very important conversion kit to try to make a different look and try to apply some corrections to the dramatic appeal of the Fujimi model. So basically what they did, it was exactly the same kit that I used here. And also that, you know, back in time, you had to become mad and don't think about the money you are spending in such project, because then it will be absolutely a bloodbath. That's why, I mean, you have to start with the ordinary plastic box of the M3 E30. Ordinary kit, also reissued recently. It's still, I think, in the catalog, because they still go on presenting the car with the, I think it's quite incorrect, because on the box art they have a very, very nice box art of the real car, and it's absolutely stunning. You say, hey, this is the M3, why not? It's lovely, you know, without all the markings and so on. So in this model I had to add Fujimi kit, then I had to add the Studio 27 correction set, then I had to add Studio 27 BBS rims. In this car I wanted to do it with the rain setup. I also placed a Tamiya wheels, Tamiya tires coming from the Porsche 993 RSR that made Tamiya, and the decal sheet that was, I don't remember honestly, but it's quite famous. I mean, if you search for Emanuele Pirro car in Macau, this was the car that he drove, so it is the only Mr. Juicy BMW number 3 car around. And the modification was absolutely huge, because you had there is some work in progress thread that they made in Automotive Forum explaining in the detail what they did to obtain the shape. I was mostly concentrated on the shape, on the line, to have an E30, you know. So basically you had to strip it down completely, the front end of the car, the front part of the car, so all the grille, all the two kidneys, typical from the BMW front, was different. So this is all this part, all this block is a complete resin brick. They provide no, not interior, just a part, I think, of the rear side of the seats, the rear wing, and the big resin mounting. That's also, that in my opinion was not so properly taken neither by Studio 27. I think, of course, the nicest model around is the one that we had since few years coming from BMAX, that is easy, you know, like to eat a perfect lobster, you know, so you just have to take the real good one and just enjoy it. So it was not exactly the same way. And I remember that I also had to cut the pillars of the car to lower the roof, cut everything. The glasses are not coming from the box, so the glasses I have to remake in acetate. the decals were different, the width, the setups. It was a nightmare. Absolutely was a nightmare, you know. But I wanted so much to finish this E30 because I like so much the vehicle, you know. Basically, back in time, Fujimi just used all the lower part for the same kit. So if you buy the Mercedes, I would make a videos about my DTM Mercedes, you know, of the 90s, the BMW, they all share the same interior, the same seats, the same undercarriage. So the same car with a different shell over, no way. And I started this model several years ago, and then I had to stop for, I guess, also some years because I didn't have no time and no way, and I lost completely the motivation to finish the model for the interior. So that's why it was absolutely safe for me when the Aoshima produced the plastic kits to find around just the sprues related to the interior. So that was an ordinary little kit, and in 1 week I could close the model because I could not start to think about a scratch build of all the interior part to make it in a racer way, so completely stripped off by seats and so on. And I didn't want to paint in black and hide, also because this specific car used by Pierre was very particular in the look, because inside and probably also the outside of the car was completely red, was painted in red. That's why if you see through the window, you don't find the classical full white or black or silver interior. This was a red car, so all the tubes, all the roll cage and so on, they were painted in red. And many say also the interior part of the car, so the engine bay and so on, was still showing the red of the original car, you know. And I just took my personal license about the rain tires, because I didn't find any proper tire that could fit the Studio 27 rims, you know, just the rims I bought from Australia from a seller in eBay, and I think I paid double than the kit, you know, when you really want to finish a model. And then of course, when I finish everything and they painted and they liked it so much, I still love this model, of course, something like a couple of hours later, maybe 2-3 days later, arrive on the market the full model made by Aoshima that everybody say, oh, looks so nice, looks so easy, and everybody could have it. So, you know, probably I think the guys in Aoshima and Macau, they were just studying what I was doing and say, when Paolo is done, then we will sell the model. So he also will be glad and absolutely happy to buy it. Also, forget to mention that in the Studio 27 kit, they also provide a side mirror that, of course, in the racing version of the M3 were different than the ordinary big palette one that you can find in the ordinary street car. This is the model, and this is absolutely, do not try this at home, or if you already did, you probably already also trashed the model. But if you want to build up and have in the collection a very nice BMW, don't do this, simply buy the Aoshima kit. And if you have the Fujimi, keep it for the chimney or burn it in the fire, because there is no way to finish in a decent way. So Model did, that's why also I wanted to do, because I copied them, I see that they made awesome work, and they really, really wanted to do. But you know, it's not a pleasure, it was mostly a suffering, because you have so many issues during the building up process that absolutely make it complicated, and after a while it's very, very easy to lose the motivation to close it. So that's it. Thanks for watching, guys, and see you in the next video.